So implicit memory is also called non-declarative memory because we cannot directly recall this type of memory. Implicit memory is a kind of memory that's made up of knowledge based on previous experiences, such as skills that we perform automatically once we've mastered them. Implicit memory resides outside of our conscious awareness. So for implicit memory, we know how to do something, for example, ride a bike, but it's difficult to describe how we can perform the skills we know how to do so well. For example, I know how to scuba dive, and I love to dive, but it's difficult for me to describe how you swim through the water, make sure you're weighted right, have to inflate or deflate your BCD. It's something you have to experience for yourself. On the other hand, Susan knows how to knit, and she can knit really pretty scarves, but if you ask her how to explain it or give you step-by-step instructions like I have, it's hard for her to do that. So for the example of Susan and knowing how to knit, she has to know where her fingers belong, where the needles go, and how to move the yarn around. This is an example of procedural memory. So procedural memory refers to the knowledge we hold for almost any behavior or physical skill we've learned. Again, this could be things like driving a manual transmission car, knitting, scuba diving, playing hockey, or any sport. Priming is another type of implicit memory. Priming occurs when recall is improved by prior exposure to the same or a similar stimuli. In fact, memory is better for information that relates to prior knowledge.